I've got a good morning, Kirby. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Not too bad. Did you have a late night doing the Conan show last night?
I did, yeah. I got home and I had such a hard time staying awake to watch it on them. I literally went to bed right when it ended.
I would think that you would have had like a TiVo or a DVR or something.
Oh, I do, but I wanted to see it right when everybody else did, and it was actually kind of lame because I got a bunch of calls at 8 because the East Coast, you know, had already aired it, and a bunch of people had already seen it. So, anyways, I had to stay up and watch it.
So, what were the friends' review of that? You being on the Conan show last night.
It was crazy. My mom and my brother, they're both really excited. So my friends too. I got a bunch of text messages, which is fun that my friends were watching.
Well, of course, the spotlight is on you right now because you're part of this brand new movie that came out. Came in at number 2 this last week. Not too bad. It's called Project X, and that movie is kind of a crazy, fun movie for I would imagine not only to watch, but it probably was to make.
Oh yeah, we had a great time. We had a great time. I mean, I was nocturnal for like 2 weeks straight, but we had a fun time making it, and everything we did, I feel like we did bigger and better than kind of has been seen before. So,
well, and the movie itself, if somebody hasn't seen it, it's more or less like one huge party, like when we're all in school, dream that, you know, oh, this would be epic to throw something this wild and this crazy.
Right, except to a certain extent, I mean, to where I would think if just one of these crazy things happened at a party, it would be epic. But all these crazy ideas happen like at the same party. So it's a fun ride. I mean, I feel like in the theater, you know, you're there with them. You know, you're there with all these kids, and you feel like you're a part of it. And, you know, I'm getting 2 different reactions leaving the theater. I'm getting that most of the people either want to take a nap and they're just drained and they feel like they've just partied hard, or they want to go party. So.
And what do you think on some of the stuff and the events that happened during the movie? Do you think that's going to be duplicated by a lot of people going, hey, man, I saw this in Project X. We can do that.
Oh, I hope not. I really hope not, because we had set medics and there was a lot of money involved, and we, you know, it wasn't a real neighborhood. I mean, it's for your entertainment. Come on. I think there is a warning at the beginning, but kind of like on that MTV show, we should do, like, don't try this at home.
Yeah, don't try this at home. Well, let me ask you this. I mean, you came from, a background that was a little tamer with stuff on the Disney Channel and Nickelodeon, right, with Zoe 101 and Unfabulous on Disney. What was it, Hannah Montana? So now this is taking you to a different direction. Is this the direction kind of you want to break away from that little more pristine mode?
Yeah, I mean, this was a lot of fun. I still get to play the good girl kind of, but you know, this is a lot of fun because I get to be a tomboy, and you know, just being a part of a comedy is definitely something I'm really, really, you know, I had already set out to do that. So the fact that I got to do this comedy, which is, you know, even bigger than I expected. So it succeeded my expectations.
Well, let me ask you about that. You do play the role as the tomboy in the movie, but how much of that is parallel to what you are? Would you consider yourself a tomboy?
Oh, yeah. That's more me than absolutely. In fact, some of the stuff was even too girly for me. It was funny. I'm very much a tomboy and always have been. So I have brothers, and most of the time I hang out with guys instead of girls. So.
What would shock people when they got to know you that you do that is really along that tomboy side that you really like doing, and they're going, ew, you do that?
I'm trying to think. I really don't like dressing up, and I don't really wear makeup unless I have to, like unless, you know, there's someone there being paid to do it. I'm trying to think. I eat a good amount, too.
Do you go out frogging and that kind of stuff when you're little?
Oh, I would climb trees for hours, and my parents would be like, where have you been? I come home all muddy.
Up in a tree. Well, all right, so this was a cast of folks not necessarily big and wide known yet. How did you come about landing the role that you got?
Well, you know, as you had said, I had done some stuff when I was younger on television, so I had already had an agent, but this is the first time that I had ever heard of anything, you know, like this, where they were casting unknowns. And I'm like, hey, I've been doing this a while, but I'm still kind of, I'm unestablished. So I just gave it a whirl. And some of my friends that have bigger credits, they weren't even willing to see. So I felt really, really fortunate in the fact that I actually got a chance, because I have been working at this for a long time. So even though an agent did get me, you know, into the room, I still kind of, I got my way.
Do you feel like you have to kind of justify yourself? Like, hey, I have earned this right to be here and get this?
It's funny because, you know, there's some kids that weren't even actors, which is great because that's what they were wanting, more organic, you know, more natural.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, I just feel like I've been doing this a long time and I can do this too. So I'm just glad that they gave me a chance.
Oh, good for you. Good for you. And let me ask you this, because you have experience around the set. Was this kind of all scripted out, or is there any point where things were just kind of turned loose and let the party happen?
No, we definitely had to stick a line, but we would kind of place things and then let them happen. So, like most of my scenes, since I am kind of the only storyline, I have to kind of stay. We didn't get to improv too much. I did with Thomas a little bit, but the boys got to improv a lot just because they have a comedic background. JB and Oliver, who plays Costa. So, but, you know, we still had that party feel. At one point, we had, like, 200 extras, and we would just kind of put the music on and kind of just say go, and two different cameras would go around just catching, you know, different dancing sequences mm-hmm. or whatever. So it was a lot of fun, and we did get a chance to just kind of play as well.
Oh, cool. I've got to ask you one last question, and then we've got to wrap things up. Kirby is also the role that you played in the movie, but you're Kirby Bliss Blanton. How come the three names? Is there a reason why we use all three of your names? I mean, I like it.
Oh, no. Yeah. My mom, actually, her maiden name is Bliss, so that's my middle name, and my last name is Blanton, and I just decided, I know Kirby Blanton probably would have been unique enough, but I just decided to go my full name.
Oh, okay. Like I said, I really like it. I just had to find out the answer to that one.
Oh, no, of course. I appreciate you asking. I appreciate the curiosity.
Well, listen, I'm sure at one point everybody is going to know your name. It's becoming well-known now. This Project X is out at the theaters. Go see it. Have fun. And if you get a chance doing all, get done all these radio things, go get some sleep, okay, Kirby?
Okay, yeah, I'll try.
Hey, thanks for being on the program.
Thanks for having me.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.